Hello friends, I am Dr. Monil Verma. Welcome you all in this lecture 8, the structural analysis of material using system. This is a part of molecular modeling through system, which is hands and tutorials for beginner. Objectives of this lecture is an overview on output file of system run after the successful optimization of a structure. Then the structural analysis using different visualization tools like Molden, JMOL, X-Christian, etc. And the measurement of bond length, bond angles, lattice constant and volume. For visualization of optimized structure of material, we can use Molden, JMOL, X-Christian. And for lattice constant, we have a good approximate value which is obtained through variation of lattice constant with energy. We have used this script in the previous lecture when we are trying to optimize this lattice constant for this material. But if you want to compare this lattice constant with experimental result given in literature, then you should take the value of lattice constant and corresponding volume of the cell using curve fitting. And we can use Morgan equation of states. And I want to include one separate lecture in this Morgan equation of state and how to curve it in a separate lecture. So now let us start using my system. And we are using the system lithium ferrous Li2Fe P2O7. So let us start the demonstration part. This is my home directory where I have this directory for the demonstration. And this is the folder for structure analysis. And this is the output file. And this is the input file used for the optimization of system. And the second, this is the output file, which is available along with several other files in the same Optim directory. So let me show how it was optimized. And this is the parent directory where we have used this cutoff optimization, k-point optimization, lattice optimization, the funnel optimization, and there are so many other files available here along with this output file. And I have copied that some important files from this directory Optim to this structural analysis folder. So this is that output file. And in this output file, one can see the details of cistern, and this part gives the information regarding pseudo potential, and then number of CG steps used with several iteration. And my system, this system is fully structure optimized using about 113 CG steps, 114 and I think more than 114. Oh, sorry, some more steps are there. So 117 and then okay, yes, so it takes 117 CG steps for complete optimization. And one can see this atomic force in electron volt per angstrom. This is very minimum, approximately equal to zero. And my system is fully converged also, one can see here. And the total energy after optimization is this is the cell volume 271 in angstrom unit, and this is the total energy in electron volt of this system containing 24 atoms per unit cell. Okay, so this is my output file after system run. So what actually I want to show you. Anyways, okay, so now we have some more files for structure analysis. One is this XYZ file, and next is this animation file ANI, and obviously these two files are also available in same Optane directory. So let me show the structure of this system. So first of all, I will use Molden to see this animation file. Which will show you, this is the system, and with atoms and atomic number, and during optimization process some one can see the variation in its position by this animation file, but it's that variation is very less because this one is one stable structure. So one can see this, one can use this animation file to see the variation during optimization, and then we will have this XYZ file to see the structure. Obviously I'm using the same level in system, and one can have this simulation box like this. This is system. If you want to measure the bond length and as well as that bond angle, then one can use this distance measurement tool. So let us measure this too, and here this bond length in between this oxygen and ferrous is about 2.115, and one can use this to measure the distance between these two also. Okay, this is also 2.16296 angstrom, and for angle measurement one can use this tool. So let us measure the angle between these three atoms by clicking. So this angle is about 85.496 degree. So one can measure bonds, various bonds under study, as well as angles in between two bonds, and you can save this structure by taking its snapshot using this tool. So now structure is saved, and this is that structure saved, and one can use this structure for further publication process. Now let me use XCrystal for the same XCrystal with this. This is the structure and coordinate system, and then atomic symbols. Okay, sorry, I think there is some system, and then this atomic symbol, and also one can measure distance as well as that bond angle and the distance between two atoms. So this is the coordinates of these two atoms, and one can measure that So this is two atoms, and one can measure the distance in angstrom as well as in Bohr, 2.163 angstrom. And also next, let me measure this distance between lithium and oxygen, atom number 3 and 8, atom number 2 and 13, and this distance is about 2.05. this is the bond length between lithium and this. And also one can measure angle. So let me measure the angle between these. Let me measure this. So this is the angle between this atom, oxygen, ferrous and oxygen, that is about 71.344 degree. Now one can save this structure by using this print command, and this will be in form of PNG, and that let me save this in form of EPS. This is very standard format. So okay, so this structure has been saved, and this is now one can manipulate this using by this is don't recover this is the structure interactive structure. So yeah, this one. One can manipulate all this image by using this GNU image manipulating program and built in this CentOS operating system. So yeah, this is now available for manipulation. Anyways, now let me use JMOL for the same. So first of all, I have to go to JMOL directory to open it. So it is taking some time. Oh yeah, why this, I don't know, but now let me open that file available in that directory, within that demonstration. And for structure analysis, I have this XYZ file. This is the structure. Now display part, labels, symbols, these are the symbols, and then the display part, boundary box, this is that box. So I can change the background of this system. And now one can measure by using same method. One can measure that distance in, it is given in nanometer. One can change that unit in the distance unit in angstrom, and calculate the value of bond length in angstrom. Anyway, so one can use any of these tools for the measurement of bond and bond angle, and obviously volume, and for the lattice constant measurement we will use curve fitting method. this lecture, after the successful completion of this student, I believe that the student will have will able to study the bond length, bond angle, even that lattice constant and cell volume of optimized structure of material under study. This is my research group. And finally, I am very much thankful to my guide Dr. R.C. Agrawal, Dr. R. Pandey sir, and Dr. Rodrigo for their kind help and blessings. Thank you all, and don't forget to give your valuable feedback.